it's Tammy with Real Southern Woman.
See, here's somebody already called me. She says, diet does have a lot to do with cancer, and I'm a cancer survivor, and I beg to differ, okay? Now, there's a lot of people that think that dieting can keep you, can heal you from cancer, and they've lost their beloved mind. And there's a lot of people who believe that you got cancer because of what you were eating, and they probably have lost their mind too. But now there are some cancers that are related to your lifestyle and your environment. And then there are some cancers that are not. So I'm going to give you an example, okay, and then we'll come back to mom. My cancer, which is triple negative breast cancer, was absolutely not related to anything. When I did my medical research and I did my DNA testing, which I did, they said there was absolutely no genes in my body that had any kind of cancer genetics, okay? They also said that the type of cancer that I had was not an environmental cancer. Now, what that means is that I didn't get my cancer because I was around something or that I ate something and it helped bring on my cancer. Okay, now, my grandmother had bladder cancer, and they have proven. And some of y'all may have bladder cancer or may have had bladder cancer or may have someone in your family that did, and they've proven that bladder cancer, and this is what the DNA lady told me, it's caused mostly from secondhand cigarette smoke. So a lot of people who get bladder cancer, and it's strange, but they grew up in the home or lived with someone that smoked cigarettes, okay? It's environmental. Kidney cancer. My grandmother had bladder cancer. That was an environmental cancer. Kidney cancer, when I was talking to the DNA girl, I said, well, my grandfather on my dad's side had kidney cancer. I said, is that environmental? She said, yes, it can be. And I said, well, what could he have been around that would have caused him to have kidney cancer? And she said, I said, he had well water. They drank well water their whole life. And she said it could have very well been the well water that caused his kidney cancer. Now, does it mean that everybody that drinks well water will get kidney cancer? Absolutely not. There are people that grew up in that home and drank well water just like Granddaddy did, but he got the cancer, okay? My grandmother, Howard, she had the bladder cancer. Does it mean that everybody that grows up in a home with someone who smokes gets kidney cancer? Absolutely not. So what people don't realize about cancer is that every single one of us have genes and DNA and all, and we have these cells in our body that can become cancer. Every one of us. And every once in a while, we have a cell in our body, like in my breast cancer, that decided that it was going to multiply. And what happens is it starts multiplying at a very fast rate. And it continues to multiply. Normally, your body would automatically cut it off and keep it from growing. And our body probably keeps cancer from growing in us all the time. But for some reason, sometimes we're just blessed with a cell that decides to go crazy and form a cancer tumor. Now, if you want to get down to the nitty-gritty of it, then study what cancer really is, all cancer. Study how it grows and why it grows, and study that. Because let me tell you something. I have an engineering degree, and I'm as technical as they come. So when I got cancer, I didn't listen to everybody that said, don't read the internet. I studied it because I wanted to see if it was something that I had done to cause myself harm or whatever, and it wasn't. It wasn't. And a lot of people just throw out stuff because they don't know any better. And they throw out stuff and they throw out opinions when they really don't have a clue what they're talking about. And so let me just say that. Cancer is something that is horrible. And if you're ever diagnosed with it, and if you ever get the call and you're ever told that you have it, then you will believe. In other words, don't look at anyone who has cancer or who has had cancer and try to tell them that they've brought it onto themselves by what they ate. That's bull crap. It's horrible, it's wrong, and it's mean, and it hurts them, okay? Don't do it. Don't act like you're some kind of doctor and professional and that you're all-knowing and that you think if they'd have done this or if they'd have done that, they wouldn't have got cancer. Don't do that to people, okay? Just like I'm a survivor, and I was a stage 3C triple negative cancer survivor. Y'all, the odds were way out of my favor for my type of cancer. It's very, very aggressive. I had it 12 lymph nodes in 2 places in my breast, and it grew very rapidly. It was growing at a 97th percentile rate, okay? Now, with my cancer, my statistics were horrible. My statistics were that it would come back within a year and kill me so fast that when it comes back, I would be dead within 6 months. And it was very, very unlikely that I would make it past 3 years. And I've made it 8 years. Now, does that mean everybody will make it 8 years? No. Does that mean I was happier and had a good attitude and that's why I survived? No. Does it mean that because I was healthy and I ate better that I survived? No. We don't know who's going to survive. We don't know why they survive. If they did, if anybody knew that, they'd be rich. Okay? Only God knows why I'm here. Only God knows why I survived. And I'm not any better than the next person that didn't. I'm not any holier than the next person that didn't. I'm not any healthier. I'm not any smarter. God don't pick favorites. And so it makes us survivors feel bad when people don't survive and we do, because we feel like, why did they survive and I didn't? And vice versa, you know, just because I survived don't mean more people prayed for me. It don't mean I had more faith. It doesn't mean any of that. There's a lot of faithful, sweet Christian people who don't survive cancer. Only God knows our life and our plan and our future. And we shouldn't tell people to do this or that with, you know, with their cancer. We shouldn't say things like that to people. But anyway, that's one of my pet peeves, y'all. Until somebody looks at you and says, you have cancer, don't tell people what they should eat or drink, okay? Because I just think it's hogwash. I really do. I really think it's hogwash. Now, do I think it's hogwash for our health? No. Do I think it's hogwash for our degenerative diseases? No. That's not what I'm trying to say. I'm just trying to say that you can't save yourself with healthy, holistic, natural things. People try to do it all the time and they die. And some people make it, but I mean, it's just according to our bodies and our makeup and how much our body is going to fight it, how much it's not going to fight it, how much some people can't take the chemotherapy, it don't work, and then some people can. You just don't ever know. I mean, so just don't ever blame people for the predicament they're in when it comes to health.